I'm John Grimshaw and I'm director of the Yorkshire Arboretum. The Yorkshire Arboretum is a collection of trees and shrubs, hardy in North Yorkshire, growing outside in 120 acres, 50 hectares of grounds near Castle Howard, not far from York. There's two things for conservation, there's in situ and ex situ. Well, of course, we're growing mostly plants from overseas at the Yorkshire Arboretum, and so that is ex situ, out of their own locality. And it means that we have a collection of things that have come from all over the world, from Chile, Kenya even, China especially, and we have populations of them, several plants of each in many cases. And therefore they are safe, we hope, from ravages of disease or forest clearance or whatever it is in their home country, while of course giving people here the opportunity to see them for themselves. We also do in situ conservation of British native species. We have a very wide diversity of British native plants. We've been working very hard on habitat management and so forth, which encourages them and all the other biodiversity, the insects especially, that live with them. So we have a dual purpose, ex situ conservation for our collection and in situ conservation for our native fauna and flora. How we choose to conserve plants is an interesting question. There is very little, I think, selective choice going on. People are collecting, when they go to foreign countries, overseas places, collecting things that are available in seed is very often the critical thing. Or they're going for a focused research purpose and collecting a particular group of plants for their own research program. There isn't, I think, a great deal of coordinated conservation work. It all helps, but I don't think there's as much coordination as possible. Clearly, some things are very rare. We think of the wallamy pine from Australia, a few individuals down the bottom of a canyon. That has been brought out, propagated by the New South Wales Conservation Department, and made available to gardeners to keep it safe, promote it, make a bit of money for the conservation process along the way. But in general, it's a bit random, unless something is really rare and obviously has to have a rescue mission. When I was in Tanzania many, many years ago now, I was studying the ecology and flora of Mount Kilimanjaro, which you would have thought was a pretty well-known spot. It's been botanized since the 1850s. And so very many people have been there and looked at the plants. So it's unusual to find something that is unfamiliar. But by being intensively and regularly on the ground and looking at everything and collecting material, the specimens of all the plants found, these things popped up as just not really fitting any description that I could find in the literature. And so alarm bells begin to go off, and you think, this is odd, why doesn't this fit? And so that's out in Africa, and then you collect your specimen, make a herbarium specimen of it, take it back to UK in this case, and or could try a herbarium in Africa. But you then have to go into the process of looking at all the nearest relatives in the herbarium collections, checking through the literature, and finding out whether it really is something different, as you are already suspecting. And that is really the point where you think, actually, this does not match anything that has been described before. And you think, yes, and then you take it to a wiser and more senior person, probably, and get an opinion. And eventually it's agreed that, yes, this probably is a new species. And then it has to be described, so a formal description has to be prepared. Formerly it had to be in Latin, now it can be in English, which I think is much easier, but less picturesque and less historic. I think all mine have been described in Latin. And then that's published and it's out there as a new species.